Hello and welcome to today's Daily Market Update with me, Joshua Mahony, Research Analyst here at Alpari UK. European indices are down today and some of the US futures are also down. This comes off the back of yesterday where we actually saw some of these indices actually reaching multi-year highs and the likes of the S&P all-time highs. Now they didn't sustain for the time being and people are going to be watching as to whether we are going to see a pullback from that as a reaction or actually breaking higher and start setting some newer highs on a longer term basis really. Now today is actually quite a quiet day in the markets. There's, you know, only a few events really that are likely to take the attention of the traders. One of the major events really within the European region is the release of EU economic forecasts. Now this ordinarily doesn't really have too much of an impact on the markets. However, this time round, we are actually looking with a little bit more intensity because of the fact that Mario Draghi recently said that it's, you know, some of these figures that he's going to be actually using to try and determine whether the European region is actually strong enough or whether it actually does need to be propped up by the means of monetary policy. That decision is next week from the ECB, and so we are actually going to see what the releases are today from the European Union in terms of the strength of the economy going forward and also in terms of the level of inflation going forward and what their perception is for the coming year. And they're going to likely, you know, use this in terms of how they're going to determine monetary policy at next week's meeting. Now, inflation, we did actually see on Monday, we saw the inflation figure revised higher to 0.8% in the Eurozone. However, later this week, we are actually going to be having the most up-to-date first release of inflation for last month. And really, that is going to be absolutely key going forward because it's the latest indication of what the inflation rate is. Now, it has been revised up to 0.8%, and thus, it staved off some of those fears in relation to a potential deflationary period for the Eurozone. Should we move anywhere near deflation, it's likely that they are going to take more monetary policy steps. Now, you know, that release later in the week, we are going to be looking to see if it is on an upward trajectory and therefore some of the fears can be allayed. Or if it does start moving back towards the downside, then again, it's a case of Mario Draghi and the like coming to look at it and seeing whether the risks are there for a potential deflation and that they might need to take some further steps in the future. Now, that's about it for the European session. Looking ahead, we do have the consumer confidence figure over in the US, which is expected to fall. Now, consumer confidence is key given the fact that around about 70% of GDP in the US is made up from consumer spending. Therefore, if we have a confident consumer base, then it means that it's likely that they are actually going to go out and spend, and that is going to drive the US economy going forward. Where we do see a pullback, then that means potentially people are wavering somewhat and potentially holding off on big investment decisions. So that's going to be a key release later in the afternoon, but that's about it really in terms of what is going on today. So that's it for today, guys. If you want any more news and analysis, come and check out the Alpari newsroom at alpari.co.uk/newsroom or check me out on Twitter. My name's Joshua Mahony, research analyst here at Alpari UK. Have a great day.